603. It's got 2G, 3G, and 4G LTE. If we turn this over, we can see the color options that we've got for the Z3. We've got a white, copper, and black. You can purchase the copper and black from clove.co.uk sim-free. A little bit of the technical specifications that we've got on the phone here. So we've got a tri-luminous display, X-Reality for mobile, we've got 4K video recording, we've got digital noise cancelling, we've got a 20.7 megapixel camera, 2.5 gigahertz quad-core processor, IP65 and 68 rated, 5.2-inch display, Wi-Fi, high-res audio, IP rated again, and we've got the Android operating system. But you probably already knew that, so let's open up and show you what you get. So first things first, we've got the device, which we'll come back to in just a moment. And then, because this is a sample, we're missing some of the products, but we've just got some documentation that you'd expect here, a startup guide. But you'd normally have a 3-pin mains adapter, a USB cable, and a set of headphones. So the device itself then, let's get this open and show you what it's all about. So let's start by peeling off this plastic, because I know you don't like that. So that's the screen protector off, and let's pull off the protector on the back here as well. So there we have it. This is the coppered color unit, and it's actually quite a nice color. It's almost bronzy, I suppose, bronzy copper. It's quite nice. Got a bit of glossy finish on the back here from the back cover of the Z3. So let's start by taking a look at the sides of the unit here, because this is where the Z3 sort of has the main difference between the previous devices. It's much more rounded on the edges to be softer in the hand. It has decreased in terms of its overall thickness as well. You're looking at 7.3 millimeters thick, and you've got a 3100 milliamp hour battery under the back cover here. So on the front, you've got the full HD 5.2 inch IPS display. We've got a speaker at the bottom and at the top. We've got the front facing 2.2 megapixel camera. We've got the sensors up here. We've got the Sony logo. You can see it's already a bit of a fingerprint magnet. So we'll turn the screen on there just to give you an idea of what it's like. On the bottom, it's completely flush, nothing to speak of. On the left side, we've got the lanyard attachment, we've got the magnetic charging dock here, and then we've got a cover under which the micro USB connection sits. So that's for charging, data transfer. It's also got MHL 3.0 out through this port, and you've also got USB hosting as well. On the top, we've got the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and the microphone. And as you can see, there's no cover over the headphone jack there, because it's treated for the IP rating. On the right side, we've got the micro SD cover. And if we open that up, we've got the micro SD card slot and also the nano SIM card slot under there as well. So it's using that small nano SIM. It takes micro SD cards up to 128 gigabytes in capacity. We've got a slightly smaller power button than we've seen on the Xperia devices of the past. We've got the volume rocker key, and then we've got the dedicated camera key. On the back, we've got the 20.7 megapixel camera with LED flash, 4K video recording, 8x digital zoom. We've got the NFC area here, we've got the Sony logo, Xperia branding. So we've got the battery of 3100 milliamp hours under this cover, as well as the 3 gig of RAM, the quad core processor, the GPS, the GLONASS, and everything that's actually in here. The device weighs 152 grams, and with the IP rating, it can be immersed in fresh water up to a depth of 1 meter for up to 30 minutes. So you're going to be well protected should this device get wet. So let's actually have a look.